Did a track recently with Iggy Pop. How did you manage to arrange that?
We just met him in Croatia and he came up to us and said how much he liked the band. You know.
I've been listening to Van Damme music for 30 years, been waiting for a band like you kind of stuff.
And, yeah.
You know, we sent him a version of one of his songs, No Fun, which we thought would be a laugh. And he really liked it, he liked the idea, you know.
Yeah, he had fun with that.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Well, he's quite a bright person, isn't he?
He's very, yeah.
I mean, he's one of the few guys from back in the days which MTV actually allows to make any kind of comment on TV now.
That's right, yeah, it's true.
There's not many in between.
No. Well, I don't really look at it as a genre, see. I don't really like it. Do you like jazz or don't you? It's stupid.
Yeah.
Really. Sun Ra is a big idol of mine. I love Coltrane. I like almost everything from the 50s to the early 80s of Miles Davis. Chico Hamilton, I like very much. Chico Hamilton inspired, one of my first bands was just inspired by the soundtrack to Repulsion.
Yeah.
Which is an amazing thing. Very no one talks about him very much, but his stuff is really quite mind-blowing.
Yeah.
Really weird.
Yeah.
Distorted kind of discordant sort of jazz, very early on.
Yeah.
I don't know, I saw an interview with the drummer from Pink Floyd and he said that one of their songs was based on Chico Hamilton's performance on Jazz on a Summer's Day. I don't know if people know that. Yeah. Brilliant. Guitar style, I love very much. I suppose I have been quite influenced
by that thing that you don't really like.
Well, no, I didn't like it. I said I don't really, you know, it doesn't really make sense to say, do you like jazz, don't you? In many ways, it's aspects to jazz and the way it's performed or whatever that I hate.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's something to
say yourself. The fact that it's all about learning cover versions and stuff, I hate that. I like the great innovators and individuals in jazz, saving rock and saving all music.
Well, you have different kinds of musicians. I mean, there are some that, you know, in jazz who say, yeah, I'm a jazz musician. And you have people like Ornette Coleman who say, well, I don't see myself as in any genre.
That's right, or Sun Ra, or whatever. Sun Ra makes music, you know, made cosmological music,
right.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just he grew from the jazz kind of idiom, you know. But that's been a very big influence on me. Things like Miles Davis albums, like On the Corner, Dark Magus, and all these mad kind of extreme extremities, Bitches Brew, of course, Circling Around. I've been quite into a certain strand of jazz.
Yeah,
I kind of like lunatic jazz people, I suppose. I've been listening to an Anthony Braxton album, it's got all this kind of equations on the back.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I interviewed him as well.
Yeah.
I interviewed Marshall Allen from Sun Ra.
Well, Sun Ra is the ultimate for me because it's a philosophy of the entire universe and reflected in the way of life. I mean, you see, Sun Ra, you call him a jazz musician, but to me, he's more in common with Lee Perry or George Kunze.